The 10-day retreat of members of the NRM Parliamentary Caucus at the National Leadership Institute in Chankwanzi, which was graced by the party chairperson, President Yoweri Museveni, has come to an end today with 24 resolutions adopted. According to the government chief whip, Dennis Hampson Oboa, the caucus discussed the implementation of the parish development model and Emyoga programs extensively and resolved that recoveries under the PDM shall be due after 24 months, while under the Emyoga program recovery shall be due after 12 months.
But on the fact that from the zonal tours of the president, where he has been to Acholi, West Nile, and Greater Masaka, there has been concerns around the repayment period. So the president came up with a proposal of varying it to the advantage of the recipients. And you can see that we have given Ande Myoga 1 year for you to start repaying back, and the maximum is 12 months, 2 years. That is 2 years. Then under PDM, you have to pay within 24 months. Those are 2 years.
The caucus also resolved to bar MPs from the ruling party from moving private members' bills in parliament.
So the issue of a private member's bill, we are talking about multi-party democracy. We should strengthen our institutions by using our institutions.
Also done in order for us to avoid situations of many bills being returned.
Reforms in election of parliamentary commissioners were also proposed and adopted by the Chankwanzi meeting, as MPs want commissioners to be elected by the caucus instead of the Central Executive Committee, SEC.
The procedure of the NRM Parliamentary Caucus is discussed, debated, and adopted by the Central Executive Committee. That is why caucus is recommending to SEC to consider amending the rules of procedure of caucus to allow parliamentary commissioners to be elected from among members of the caucus, but in a caucus meeting.
We have established from NRM MPs that by being appointed by the SEC, backbench commissioners have not been accountable to MPs whose welfare is their business. This angered MPs, who recommended that SEC adopt the amendment of the party's rules of procedure.
It is about accountability and availability for members. Members feel that when commissioners are appointed, they don't have time to interact with them and give them updates on what is being handled. But they feel if they are elected, they will be directly answerable to the members of the caucus.
Currently, under the Administration of Parliament Act, NRM designates 3 of the 4 backbench commissioners who are nominated from the MPs, and these include Solomon Silwany, the MP of Bokoli Central, Esther Afoyo-Chan, woman MP of Zombo District, Prosy Akampulira, woman MP Rwanda District, while opposition has a single slot which fell vacant after censure of MP Francis Zake. However, MPs are concerned that the current set of commissioners have not addressed their welfare issues, especially issues to do with fuel allowances, which MPs want to be enhanced after a rapid increase of fuel prices.
Happy with our commissioners? We are not. We are not happy. We are grieved. As members, we are not happy. As what is in the public domain, that we are here for money. We are not here for money, but we are here for our rights.
Members of MPs who are independents, that arrangement has not been fair to us. We are 74 in numbers, more than the opposition members of parliament, but we are not represented on the commission.
MPs have also been cautioned on indiscipline on the floor of parliament.
Party, we have an issue on the floor, or we have a position to support, it will always be ideal that we agree and move as a family. But you find they have brought an issue, which is a party issue, you find other members are, disagreeing and say, no, we can't accept. Yet this is a party position. And the person disagreeing is a flag bearer, came on the party ticket. So those are the issues that we are trying to cure.
The caucus also discussed and supported government strategy on coffee chain value addition strategy, which is expected to revive the controversial coffee agreement between the government and the Uganda Vinci Coffee Company. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.